Welcome everybody. I'm Bob Lund.
And I'm Chris Raffard.
From the Fastenal engineering team. We're here today to talk about markings on nuts, bolts, and washers so that you understand what type of a bolt it is that you're dealing with just by looking at the head of the fastener or somewhere on the nut or the washer. Sounds like thrilling material, Chris.
Riveting stuff, if you ask me.
Oh, gosh. Let's start off with bolts. Let's go to the inch world. Most of the bolts in the inch world that people use are from an SAE J429 standard, which has a grade 2, a grade 5, and a grade 8 in it. Let's talk about how those bolts are marked. Yeah. Why don't you start off with the grade 2?
Well, grade 2 is pretty easy. There's really no identifying markings other than the manufacturer's head mark.
Okay, so that's the lowest strength class there is. It's just plain steel, so the thought process is we'll tell you when we go stronger, but this is as low end as it goes.
Correct.
Okay. We've got three lines on the head of this bolt. This is a grade 5 bolt. Why there's not five lines on the head of a grade 5, I don't know. But this tells us we have a grade 5 bolt. The grade 8 bolt actually has six lines on it, as well as some funky little symbol. What am I looking at there?
Well, that six line's going to denote the grade 8, like you mentioned. But the triangle, in this case, that funky symbol, mm-hmm. is the manufacturer's mark. So manufacturers, they can trademark alphanumeric characters.
Okay. So we know who it is that's making the part. If there's ever a failure, we know who to go to talk about it right away.
Right.
Okay. A grade 5 bolt is 120,000 pounds per square inch, or PSI strong. Grade 8 is 150,000 PSI strong. Even though we know what grade we're dealing with, we're still going to have to look in some of our reference materials, like our technical reference guide, to find out just how strong it is. But at least we know that we have a grade 5 or a grade 8. Nuts are also marked. We have, in this case, a grade 8 nut. Very tough to see. I'm not sure if the camera will pick this up, but we've got a manufacturer's mark here as well, and we've got two lines that are radial lines on this head. What's that telling me?
Yep, and those are going to denote the grade. Depending on the spacing between those lines, it's either going to note our grade 8. In this case, they're going to be 60 degrees apart. If they're grade 5, they're going to be 120 degrees apart, and that's going to correspond with its mating bolt.
Okay. And on the various grades that we'll see out there, there could be dots or dimples on flanges. The number of dots, dimples, lines, and the location of those lines are going to tell you the type of grade you're looking at. You could also have a number, a 2H, for example, stamped right on the nut. In the washer world, we've got low-carbon washers and hardened washers. That's basically it in the inch world. I see a marking on this. What's that telling me?
Well, not only does it tell you it's the manufacturer.
Okay.
In this case, it's YS. Mm-hmm. But also, because it is stamped with the manufacturer's mark, that's going to tell us that it has been hardened through a heat treat process.
Okay. So we use a hardened washer with a hardened bolt and a mating nut of the same grade.
Correct.
I guess we should pause for just a second to mention that if you're using a grade 8 bolt, you should probably use a grade 8 nut. A grade 5 bolt goes with a grade 5 nut, and so on. Give me a short reason why.
Well, the short answer is we want the bolt to be the weak point of the assembly. When that's the case and it's designed properly, the bolt is what will fail, right? A bolt's going to fail, it's going to fall into two pieces laying on the ground and give a maintenance person a fighting chance to probably identify a problem before they fire up a really expensive machine.
Excellent. So the nut itself has already been engineered, a grade 8 bolt and a grade 8 nut. If you pull them in tension in a tensile tester, it will be the bolt that breaks in that scenario.
Yes.
Okay. Let's switch to metric. We do something a little different in the metric world. We call them classes instead of grades. Not a big deal there, but we still have the same concept of the weaker bolts and the stronger bolts. How do we denote them?
Well, there, the metric world did something a little bit different than the imperial side. They give us a little usable design information, believe it or not. So probably the easiest to start with would be property class 8.8, and that corresponds really closely to the grade 5 type of strength. But rather than being in pounds per square inches, we're in
Well, megapascals, I guess.
Correct.
Whatever that is. But it's really the metric version of PSI. And if we're looking at the inch stuff, we have to look up a table to see what strength grade 5 correlates with. Then what I like about the metric world is that 8.8 is telling me it's 800 megapascals strong. So I'm adding two zeros to the number to the left of the decimal point. The 10.9, tell me about that.
Well, the 10.9 is going to be very similar. So it's 1,000 megapascals for its ultimate tensile strength. That's the point at which it'll break. But we also find in the design world that the yield point is very critical. And to the right side of that decimal point, that's what we're talking about, is 90% of that 1,000 megapascals is its yield point, so 900 megapascals.
Gotcha. That makes sense to me. And yielding is really where you've stretched it to the point where it's no longer elastic. It's not springing back to the same size that it was before you put the load on the bolt and tightened it and started stretching it.
Yep.
Okay, that makes sense. Nuts in the metric world. I don't see an 8.8 and a 10.9 nut.
We're sticking in the class designations. It's actually really easy. So your 8.8 bolt should mate with a class 8 nut. Your 10.9 bolt should mate with a class 10 nut. And the markings are going to be really nice and user-friendly that way, where you're going to see an 8 for the class 8 or a 10 for the class 10.
So we don't have that 0.8 or 0.9, but there's no yield strength in the nut, so they don't bother with that. And again, we have a 4.6, a 4.8 for the lowest strength, and we have a 12.9 for the really high strength stuff in the metric world.
Correct.
Okay. Let's move on to stainless really quickly. In the inch world, we've got standard ASTM rates a standard F593, and that's probably the most common standard that people will see and the most common marking.
Yeah, so you will see F593 marked on these fasteners. There's also going to be a letter after it,
which tells you kind of the size range for that.
Diameter range, yeah.
The smaller stuff, okay. They also have a different standard, ASTMA 193 and 4, where you may see something like B8 or B8M. The concept here is to tell people that we've got markings that will teach us things, not that everyone's supposed to memorize all of these standards.
Yeah, why memorize it when we have this handy technical reference guide for you, which we'll include a link to.
Bet they can find that on Fastenal.com.
Sure can.
Okay. Do we talk about stainless steel in the metric world yet? Let's do that quickly.
Absolutely.
A2 and A4 here, and instead of the F593 alloy groups 1 and 2, we go to A2 and A4. What does that mean?
Well, the A2 is really your alloy group 1, your 18-8 type of stainless. The A4 would be the 316 types of stainless.
So more corrosion resistance.
Yep.
And in the metric world as well, stainless, we have an A2-70, which is your standard cold worked part, an A280, which is strain hardened and stronger. We're talking, the 70 and 80 are telling us the megapascals again, 700 or 800. And then there's a 50, which is pretty rare. What does that mean?
So that means we've actually put it through essentially a heat treat process to anneal or soften it. Because of the cold working that happens in the forming of stainless parts, it can add some magnetism in there. And we do certainly have customers that cannot have any magnetism.
Yep.
When you do that, you pull some strength out of it so that it's a 500 megapascal type of fastener rather than the 700.
Great. Well, we hope this has been useful. We have this information and a whole lot more in the technical sections of Fastenal.com. You can reach us at engineer@fastenal.com. Perhaps we'll come out and do a training for any customer that's interested.
Absolutely.
Okay. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.